Do you ever worry about your bone health? Well, what if I told you that 1 in 3 females and 1 in 5 males over the age of 50 will suffer from the silent condition and you may not even know you have it? Additionally, osteoporotic or fragility fractures are more common than heart attack, stroke, and breast cancer combined. Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. We're gonna talk about a condition that affects millions of people that's rarely ever talked about, osteoporosis. Stick around as we uncover what this condition really is, some really important signs to be aware of, and then most importantly, how to protect yourself. For those who don't know me, my name is Dr. Zach Greenwade here at Performance Sport and Spine in Seattle, Washington. Well, it turns out through our life, our bones are always getting built up and broken down. But with osteoporosis, this building up slows down and the breaking down speeds up. Therefore, your bones become less dense and unhealthy and increases your chance for fracture. So why does this condition happen? Well, there's many factors in play, but let's look at the big ones. So first, there's actually two types. There's primary and secondary osteoporosis. So primary is postmenopausal, age, and then idiopathic, which means sometimes this happens and we don't quite know why. But osteoporosis definitely happens as we get older. Now, secondary reasons are like immobilization. So let's say you break your arm and you have to have a cast for 6 months, that can cause it. There's also like endocrine, so hormones come into play, especially estrogen, metabolic issues, and then illnesses like diabetes can definitely cause this condition. But age is one of the biggest ones. And then crazy enough, after 30, we start to lose our bone density and mass if we don't exercise regularly. Gender matters, as females are much more likely to get this than males, and a family history. So if your parents or maybe grandparents or aunts or uncles have it, it increases your chance to have it. One thing to note is postmenopausal. So after the 5 years of menopause, women lose 3 to 5% of their bone mass, and then 1% after that if they don't do interventions. Now you may be wondering, well, how do I know if I have osteoporosis? And this can be tricky, especially in the early stages as there's no obvious signs. But here's some great things to look out for. First is frequent fractures. So if you have fractures that happen often, you want to have this addressed, especially if they happen in the spine, the hip, the upper arm, or the wrist. Secondly is persistent pain. Again, this is more in the elderly population, but collapsed vertebrae or fractures in the spine can cause pain. Third is a loss of height. Now, unfortunately, as we age, we're all going to shrink a little bit, but people with osteoporosis often shrink faster than normal. In addition, as your bones get weaker, your back might start to bend a little bit, called hyperkyphosis, which will make you more stooped, so that's something to be aware of. Also, when you have this, sometimes your knees start to bend when you stand to compensate. Lastly, you might find, or people will comment on your posture, you have a stooped or hunchback posture. And not only can this affect mechanical or structural issues, but because this puts pressure on your abdomen and chest, you can have problems with breathing and digestion as well. Now that we know what causes it and some signs and symptoms to be aware of, let's talk about the best test to really know if you have it or not. And that's called the DEXA scan. And what this does is a non-invasive way of attesting the bone mineral density and the bone structure. And how this test works is as you have this scan, there's 2 low dose x-rays that pass through your bones. And the difference between the absorption helps them determine the bone mineral density. And this is great for diagnosing things like osteoporosis, as well as monitoring the effectiveness of bone treatment disorders. The DEXA scan is quick and painless and often recommended for people that have an increased chance of fracture, such as age, gender, or social factors. How this DEXA scan is scored is called the T-score, and it's a classic bell-shaped curve. And these numbers are all based off of a 25-year-old female. So how this works is if you have minus 0.1 or higher, you're normal. If you're between minus 1 and minus 2.5, it's called osteopenia, which is like the precursor of osteoporosis. It's a less serious condition. And then if you have greater than minus 2.5, you have full osteoporosis. I don't think anyone would argue that if you go to the gym and work out, your muscles are gonna get stronger. But sometimes with things like bones or cartilage, we think that stress is gonna damage them. Well, the opposite is true. So there's this principle in bone physiology called Wolff's law. And what this means is that bones will respond to mechanical stress placed upon them. Put more simply, bones adapt to the forces that are used. So let's say that you regularly stress your bones through walking, running, or weightlifting, nice weight-bearing activities. Well, your bones will respond with this and get denser and stronger to help protect against future loads. Now, conversely, let's say there isn't a lot of stress placed on it. Maybe you've been very inactive or immobilized. Well, these bones will now get weaker. And this causes bone loss. And because you don't stress the bones, your body will actually reabsorb the bone, making them weaker and causing an increase in chance of fracture. This concept is essential for understanding how bones heal and remodel. For instance, people that lift weights have far more dense bones than people that don't because of the extra stress placed on them. When you're sedentary, the bones don't have stress, so they get weaker. Wolff's Law also explains how bones heal after fractures. As they repair, they remodel themselves in response to the forces placed upon them during normal movement. Therefore, regular weightlifting exercises are crucial for maintaining bone health and preventing bone density loss, especially as we age. Here are some risk fractures for people over the age of 50. A fragility fracture after the age of 40, prolonged use of glucosteroids, which means 3 months out of the last year, falls of two or more in the last year, parental hip fracture, you're currently smoking, high alcohol intake, more than 3 units per day, a BMI of less than 20, or causes of secondary osteoporosis. The most common sites due to osteoporosis for fractures are the distal radius, which is the small bone of the forearm by your wrist, the spine, the humerus, which is a large bone on your upper arm, or the proximal femur, or your hip bone. And in the spine, the most common sites are T7 to T8 and T11 to L1. And this is thought as this is the area of the largest curve, therefore the most compression. The distal radius is the most common in women over 75. And people over 80 with a hip fracture, 28 to 37% unfortunately will die within 1 year, and 50% will have impaired mobility. This is arguably the most important part of this whole video. The common belief is if we have osteopenia or osteoporosis, we need to protect our bones. We shouldn't exercise or lift anything that could cause us to have an increasing chance of fracture. But recent research, especially this LIFTMOR trial, has caused us to think that we maybe need to update this belief. So what this trial did was it took about 80 women that were postmenopausal over the age of 58, and they split them into two groups that were supervised. And they met twice a week for 30 minutes. Now the first group was high intensity. So they did deadlifts, back squats, shoulder press, and then a chin up where they lifted themselves up as high as they could and then landed it softly. And they did 5 sets of 5 reps up to 80% of the 1 rep max. So really heavy weight. Now this other group did low intensity, walking, some lunges, some air squats, but low intensity of up only to 60% of 10 to 12 reps. And they did this for 8 months with supervised training. And again, the operative word is supervise. And nowhere are you saying that you should do this on your own, but what they found is that over 8 months, only one lady strained her back. There was no other serious adverse effects. And they all increased their bone density, their muscle strength, and functional performances like sit to stand, functional reach, and hopping. Here's the chart to show the progress of the people. And all these women did a DEXA scan before and after, so you know the results are valid. And this has been further collaborated with other research papers, and I myself have had women and men too that have come into the clinic, and this slow progression. Now again, this is not a fast change, but gradual progression. This was an 8-month program. And some people may be like, they're unsafe, but that's why it needs to be supervised. A trained person can help you do these movements that are safe and both get your bone density increase as well as muscle mass increase. Now, some of the people will be a little bit like, this is too much for me initially. So the next video we're gonna make are some more easy exercises that you can start with. And then once you come up with those, you can progress to these more advanced exercises with supervised training. For medications, lifestyle, nutrition, if you're smoking, definitely stop. You should stop anyway, but smoking really affects how fast bones heal. Now, nutrition, you want a well-based diet and a healthy diet, but supplements like vitamin D and calcium, now they are helpful, but they're lower hanging fruit, and don't get kind of too into like taking every single supplement you can. Resistance training exercise is by far the most important, and just a general healthy diet. For medications, here's a list of the most popular ones. Now medication is definitely something you want to talk to your doctor. This video is just to give you education information to make the best informed decision. Now one thing with the biophosphonates, if 100,000 people take it, it will prevent 2,500 falls. But 25 of those people will have serious adverse effects, including their jawbone will dissolve. Hope you found this video helpful. We really need to have this shift of osteoporosis treatment, and people need to lift weights for this and a plethora of other issues. It really is one of the holy grails of keeping both you young and functional. If you like this video, please make sure to like it and subscribe to our channel, and then don't forget to check out our other great videos.